Hey guys, welcome back to another video. If you watched my latest video, you probably have seen the process that it took for me to get like this mood and like my look.
Hey, is this thing on?
I really want to film this video because I don't know how to explain why. I just wanted to like talk about music I'm listening to of late. Does that make sense? Because you could be like, oh fuck, she really likes that stuff, maybe I should check it out. Or like, yes bitch, loving that too. Like, let me know whatever the fuck you want in the comments below, go nuts. Yeah, so basically I just want to talk about things I'm currently listening to. I'm in a really weird funk, mood, bad vibes, I don't know. But like, hopefully my love for these musics, for these artists and bands will like put me in a better mood. So I kind of just like want to make this for myself, and if other people watch it, fuck yeah. If not, really don't give a fuck. I just want to talk about things that I want to talk about. So I'm just gonna like chill out for this video, kind of take a deep breath. Do people like watching videos with people in a bad mental state? I'm not sure. So let's start off with the obvious. Well, there's two big obvious band artists that I'm currently listening to because it's been shoved in my face phone constantly. So since Bohemian Rhapsody has not come out in cinemas, but like come out like as in like downloads and fucking buying DVDs, a lot of people have been coming up to me saying like, oh my god, I've seen Bohemian Rhapsody, I love it, blah blah blah. Because you have noticed, I put myself out there a lot. Like, I don't hold back from like things I fucking love on any kind of social media. And I should really keep doing that because like it's true to myself and I shouldn't care what people think. So that's a good mindset. So people obviously know that I've been like loving it, loving Ben Hardy play Roger Taylor. Anyway, Ben Hardy, what a gorgeous man. So basically people are talking to me about him and I have been still listening to Queen to this day. I think I might have mentioned them in the last video that I did sort of like this. So obviously Queen, whatever. I just feel like I'm always in like a mood to hear a different song. Does that make sense? So like, I Want It All by Queen is a fucking song. It's not even the words Freddie Mercury sings. It's beginning B, where he's like, I want it all, hey, yeah. I don't know, he just gives me like energy and I love that. So if you're in the mood to get like something fucking pumped in you, bro, Queen is a good one to listen to, obviously. Another obvious choice, if you can't tell by the past like fucking 12 billion videos I've uploaded in the past like 6 months, Ariana Grande. Like, not as much as compared to like everyone else in this list, but like still a well good amount to be obviously included in this because the chick is fucking killing it. Which is like so lovely to see and so deserving because people on the outskirts of town. Okay, people that like aren't a fan or like don't listen to her probably just think she's another fucking pop star. But this bitch has got so much depth and so much level to her that I would hands down defend her to anyone. Like any other pop star, have your opinion. But like, there is only one opinion when it comes to Ariana Grande, okay? She is such a great feminist. I love how she loves theater. She loves anime. She loves all these weird, cool shit that just makes her so much different and she doesn't hide away from it. And she speaks out on stuff she's passionate about. And she fights back on things she's fucking passionate about and set people in their place. And that's so fucking admirable. I love for a person in her position, her power, and she's just fucking thriving on the fucking charts. Like, she's getting the recognition she deserves. Not that that matters, but it's just fucking amazing that she's getting it. She's making music that she's passionate about, and the record label's letting her do what she wants to do. She's having so much freedom in the creation she, like, music she's making. And even though I might not love all the music she's putting out there, I fucking love her as a human being so fucking much. And the universe is just being like, hey, you've been through a lot of shit, but we're trying to, like, you know, we're giving you the world now, man. And I'm like, when the fuck's that gonna happen to me? But there is no one more deserving than her to have all this great success. Like, I've listened to podcasts, I've watched in-depth interviews, like, with people that she actually, like, she has so much power now that it's just like, fuck yeah, she doesn't need to do stupid album promo, like, interviewing and fucking flying around here and flying around there. The ball's in her fucking court. Anyway, so I'm currently listening to her. That's the gist of this video, isn't it? Yeah. Love that. Another artist. Now, Yana, if you're watching this, sit the fuck down. I can't believe I'm about to say this. This has been a long time coming. My friend Yana, we've been seen in previous videos, has been trying to get me into this band since the dawn of time or age. What is that expression? Is it the dawn of time or dawn of age? Since the fucking whatever, man. Since this band probably it came around. So the band's 1975. Okay, we get it. Jackie, what? I know, right? I kind of could never ever get into them because their vibe, their music is just so like, I don't know what the right word is, electronic. And Matt Healy's voice is so like manipulated and whiny that I was like, I can't. But you know what? They have like, they're so fucking good. Like, lyrically, they're amazing. And Matt Healy, the day I'm filming this, the Brit Awards just happened, and that fucking legend of a guy. I love when people use their platforms for good, especially things that I'm like passionate about. So it's like, yes. And he was just calling out like misogyny stuff in the music industry. And I was like, oh my God, fuck it up. Like, you know what I mean? I love that. Yana maybe, well not maybe, she just like told me to watch it. And I was like, fuck yeah. The Genius videos that he did on like songs, and he talks about lyrics, and like, even if they sound annoying, the lyrics in 1975 songs are fucking, they're probably some of the best lyrics I've ever heard in like, ever. The way he words things, sometimes subtle, sometimes very fucking in your face, but like, he's very political, and I love that. Like, yes. Obviously, like, music can go very two ways for everyone and for me. Like, sometimes you kind of just like want love songs, you want chilled out kind of music, you don't want it to take it too seriously. But then I do love when people can just be very political, passionate, and la-di-da-di-da about stuff in their music, and it not be so obvious as well. So sometimes 1975, they just do a whole fucking good stuff. Like, Love It If We Made It. Why wasn't that number one worldwide? Like, everyone should fucking know that song. I think I'm gonna have a heart attack. You know the bad thing about having an iPhone 10? You know the Face ID thing? And when you go on iTunes and you want to just like buy an album, you just go fucking boom boom and it just brings your face and it's like, oh, that's purchased. And you're like, oh, fuck, I haven't even done anything. Oh, A Brief Inquiry into Online Relationships is what the album's called. So many songs are fucking amazing, okay? So obviously I just talked about Love It If We Made It. That's a really good one. Give Yourself a Try. Obviously, Two Time, it's just a fun song. Be My Mistake. Like, it's all just like very depressing. We're not meant to use that as a describing word because it's a condition. It's very just like moody, and it like puts you in like a miserable kind of mood, which sometimes you want to be. Like, you know when you're already in like a sad mood and you want to listen to sad music? That's coming up in the next thing. But like, this is just so like mellow and just moody. Like, you want to listen to on like a long drive in the rain. Sincerity Is Scary is a really good song. If you can get past the whole like sound of it, it's a really good song. It's Not Living If It's Not With You. When Yana told me that song is about Matt Healy's experience with his drug addiction and going to rehab, it changed the whole fucking meaning of the song, because I had no, I didn't like enjoy it that much. But then once you told me that and you kind of like looked the lyrics a bit from that perspective, it's like, oh, it's just genius. And kind of like, because anyone can translate it or interpret it how they want to, but like, just knowing like what the intended thing was, it's like, oh my God, you wrote it really good. I Couldn't Be More In Love. Makes me want to cry. And the last song on the album that I also really love is I Always Want to Die Sometimes. I mean, like, obviously relatable, but like, I don't mean that in a joking way either. I don't know, I think he talked about it on the Genius video. I heard him talk about it, and it's just like really nice. So like, I hate that I've gone from like, ew, 1975 to like crying about their music. Like, people grow, people change, music changes, tastes change, and that's a prime fucking example. That, and when Yana and Megan got me into Ed Sheeran for that fucking one album that is just so good. Never hold yourself to like not liking an artist, pretty much, because like, if you give him a shot, you never know. Alright, another artist I'm currently listening to, if I can just stop reading text messages, is a band that, okay, so there's like a list of like six bands that I'm like meant to get into. And it just takes me a while because I don't know. I don't know why. I just have to like feel it, and like if I listen to like one song and I love it, then I'm gonna be like, fuck yeah, let's keep going. So that's what happened with this band. And the band is called Grayscale, and pretty much they're like everywhere on every social media ever. Something made me listen to them like early January, let's say. I think it was because of the main. I'm gonna say this story and pretend I'm not like I'm not gonna think of people watching this video, I'm just gonna talk for like the sake of it, like how it played out. So I went on iTunes and I looked up Grayscale and I was like, let's see what they've got. And I think it was like an album and an EP. And I was like looking through the track list, like just thinking like what the vibes you can get just from like the track list, because you just never know. Like maybe something would stand out. And then they had a song called Mum, and I was like, okay, like, let's see what this is gonna be like. Like, is it gonna be sad? Is it gonna be love? Like, is it gonna be like The Best Day by Taylor Swift, or is it gonna be like depressing? And I was given a really good relatable song. It kind of like just set the tone. Oh my God, I'm gonna cry. So it just kind of set the tone for like the rest of like this album and like how fucking relatable this band is. But like 2 nights ago, I just spent like the whole night like listening to this album and repeat cry. Like when I mean crying, I mean like those, you know, those ugly cries where like this is snot coming out of your nose constantly. Well, that was to this album, and like everything's just so relatable about it. And I like wrote all about them in my like diary, and yeah, so I listened to the song Bob, it was just really nice, and then I listened to other songs and they're just so fucking weirdly relatable that I hate, like I love it and I hate it, because it's like, I hate it because like like other people go through it, and you kind of don't want other people to go through like what you've gone through and all this kind of stuff, but then it's also really nice because you're not alone and like other people feel the same way you feel, so you kind of feel less weird and like wrong or whatever, like you know what I mean, like it's almost like reaffirming, I don't know if that's the right word, that like people feel the same way that you do, and like it's totally fine, because like sometimes you might feel like you're the only one, and so like this band, oh my god, I haven't even liked them that long, but like they've made such a huge impact on my life that it's fun. Okay, I can do this. Yeah, so this is like lyrics, like lines in each of their songs, like it just stands out to me, and I always have to like repeat the song if I skip, you know, when people like, when you like miss your favourite bit in the song, you have to like skip and go back and listen to it again. This is like every fucking song because I have like so many favourite lines, but like my favourite song ever is Echoes Carry On, because I really like the line where it's like, oh, I really like the lyric when I was like, I still hear your echoes down the hall. Oh my god, it's just like a simple, like, stupid lyric. Like, whatever to other people, but to me, it's like, oh my god. I'm just like laughing at myself, crying about it. And I still hear my mom calling out to me. If I leave this in the video, it's so fucked. So there's just like really nice lyrics in their music that I find like fucking weirdly relatable. And how we are. They write about like the lighting bugs, because the lighting bugs are really cold, my eyes are fucking stinging now. Because they were around when his mom was alive and now they're not around anymore. Oh my god, my fucking eyes are stinging so much. I don't even know where to go from here. Trying to like just bring myself together a bit. How long have I filmed for? 17 minutes. Love that. I don't know, you guys probably know this, but I like music that makes me like, this is how I define my general music taste. I'm gonna love it. Like, hands down guaranteed, if it's gonna make me want to punch a wall or fucking go on a run, like just go on a marathon of a run, because it's just gonna put that much either anger or added energy into my body. That's why I probably like, I like a lot of like pop punk rock kind of music, because it's just like, like it just like fucking fills me up with something, you know what I mean? It kind of makes me like, feel alive. And so this band like energetic in that kind of sense, but then like their lyrics are just a whole other level, and like I really love what's his name? I follow him on Instagram because he's really cute, the lead singer. I get this much satisfaction from the main, so I don't need other bands in my life to do this for me, okay? But now we're giving Grayscale a shot, and they kind of just like fucking doing a really good job. Yeah, the lead guy, Colin, his voice is really nice. So there's a lot of really relatable lyrics. I can't even talk about them without crying. Basically, they're just really relatable, and I kind of like the way I like reading lyrics and like understanding them and all that kind of stuff. And this band like really was really good to do. But they talk a lot about like weather and like rain, or like natural elements. Is that the right way to word it? And that's kind of like, I don't know, it's just like something I never knew I needed in music. And so like the way they just talk about things, it's like, oof, just puts me in a mood, like a nice mood, and they're just really comforting band. There's just really good songs on it. Sorry, I can't talk. I can't finish this without like continue crying for the rest of the video. But like, just sing about things, and like, oh my god, it can just be simple as like seeing someone dreams, or like there's lyrics where it goes like, I miss the way you breathe and the way you twitch in your sleep. And there's other ones where it's like, why did you have to leave? I know there's a reason. Could never live without you, but I guess I'll have to. And there's like things that you can apply to like relationships, or you can obviously, in my case, you apply to like a passing of someone. I still hear your stories, the lessons you always told me. And like, that's a big one, because Whatever, I don't need to get into details. Grayscale's a really good band. Yeah. Let's just leave it at that. I don't need to cry anymore. Maybe this is what I needed, you know? Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. We've got new main music coming out. The day I'm filming this, the song comes out tonight. So let's just include the main because they're like my favorite people in the entire world. And I'm gonna cry about the main. Oh my god. Love this. I love the main. Their new album comes out at the end of March. I don't remember the date. They do. It's all over their Instagram. But yeah, new music from the main. That's what I'm thinking. They do no wrong in my eyes. They're the least problematic people in the world. They love their fans. We're a community. I'm best friends with all the members of the main. Like, you know what I mean? That's how like great it is. Anyway. Basically, this was a shit show of a video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm fine. Like, don't feel the need to like message me if you know me in real life or like just like on anything on social media. I'm fine. I just that just happens from time to time, which is fine. Grieving process is like this. It's not fucking step-by-step process like I thought, and that's totally fine. Feel your emotions, cry when you have to, don't hold it in because that's really bad for you. That's what my mom always told me. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up. Comment below your new favorite bands and like bands you think I should check out. And please subscribe. I've got new videos coming out all the time and I promise they won't be as fucking emotional as this. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you guys in my next video. And once again, I'm doing fine. Don't even bother messaging me. I have friends that care for me, so it's totally fine. Cool. Bye guys. But I still hear you.